one of the things that's very interesting in this particular, with this particular virus and this particular outbreak is really the way that we're managing it, you know, almost reactively, because we don't have as much data as we need to proactively manage it. And so one of the things I've been doing in looking at cases is to try to look by age to see if there's anything that we can predict by age group. So this first graph is the number of weekly cases by various age groups. It's worth noting that they're not even intervals. The 18 to 29 is what overlaps with the college population. So that's why it's 11 years. 30 to 49 is a 20-year age block. And I did that just so that there were fewer lines. It's already too many lines, but I was trying to condense down to have fewer lines. And I figured behaviorally, 30 to 50 year olds are roughly behaviorally the same. I did break out 0 to 11 year olds from 12 to 17 year olds, because I think they're also they're different from each other behaviorally, even though they're all children. So I thought it would be interesting to look at those lines separately. One of the things that you really see here, the gray line, those are those college students, 18 to 29. And you see the peak that happens when the universities came back, particularly related to the Greek rush activities. One of the things that's fascinating about this peak, and again, as an epidemiologist, this is not what the data would tell us with COVID, but this, the folks that were 18 to 29 got sick and then didn't pass it on to any other age groups. There's no corresponding spike in other age groups following the 18 to 29 year old spike. And honestly, that's not what we would predict. Unless it's true that the particular students that got infected during that time, they really were only interacting with each other and they weren't interacting outside in the community. And when they did go home to their parents, we know that 2/3 of them went home to their parents from doing the contact tracing. Perhaps when they went home, they really did mask and distance from their parents to stop the spillover into the households. I mean, honestly, to me, this is fascinating. I wouldn't have predicted it in a million years. I would have expected a corresponding peak in other age groups to follow. You actually do see the corresponding peak in the 0 to 17 year olds. If you look at the orange and blue lines at the very bottom, you can see, especially the orange, which is the 12 to 17 year olds, you can see the tick up that they had in cases once school started. It's way down here. It's the second from the bottom. And interestingly, there's a corresponding tick up that happens in the 50 to 59 year olds. And then over here, it looks like it's spilling into the 70 year olds. So you may see something in the younger age groups spilling into other age groups, but definitely not the 18 to 29 year olds. There's one other way we could look at this, and that's by proportion of cases. That helps you to look at the lines by proportion of cases. Here again, you can see the gray line is still those 18 to 29 year olds, and they have the bulk of the cases, and everybody else dips down accordingly when there's the college outbreak. But otherwise, you can see in general, it's pretty stable in terms of what proportion each week is represented by each age group. And again, what this tells us, you know, from a data standpoint, is that the outbreak is behaving very consistently week by week by week in terms of what demographic by age are being infected. Again, the only other deviation that you see here are those 12 to 17 year olds when they went back to school in August and September. And these are actual dates, cases by date of symptom onset or test if there were no symptoms. Most of the data you get from ADPH is date of the test because they don't want their website to have to be confusing if they report 1,000 cases one day and then go back and report, oh no, never mind, it was actually 800. So on ADPH's website, they keep it very consistent with date reported, but this particular table is date of symptom onset, which is what epidemiologists would typically use. We're usually looking for symptom onset, not date of case report, when we're trying to model trends and predict future outbreaks.